नमस्कार, स्वागतम अवॉम वेलकम टू द सिक्स्थ सेशन ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस द ब्लिस ऑफ शिवानंद लहरी। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड एट वर्सेस इन द प्रीवियस क्लास, सो लाइक आई सेड टुडे वी विल लर्न 9 एंड 10। एंड एज यूजुअल, सो लाइक वी वर डूइंग इन आवर प्रीवियस वेबिनार्स, आई विल चैंट 1 to 10 continuously as a matter of revision, and also we will extract that 1 to 10 chanting and put it up as a separate video on YouTube. So those who want to just listen to 1 to 10, you could do it, and you will also have hopefully 1 to 100 soon by the time we complete the webinar or so. And after we complete learning the new verses today, then those who want to chant, please raise your hand. And you will be able to revise the verses we have learned so far. As usual, let us commence with Guru Vandanam. Are you all able to hear me? Please let me know if you're. I hope there is no problem with the audibility. I hope you have you're able to hear me. Okay, I'm audible. Thank you. Yes, those who are having some problems, you please check the volume in your system because I think others are able to hear well.
सहास्मि नमो गुरवे न गुरो परमं शिशुरस्मि गुरोः मतिरस्ति गुरौ मम पाहि गुरो। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशङ्करल्लोकशङ्करम्। सौन्दर्यलहरी कर्त्रे सर्वमङ्गलदायिने शङ्कराचार्यवर्याय यतिराजाय ते नमः। शङ्कारूपेण मच्चित्तं पङ्कीकृतमभूद्यया किङ्करी यस्य सा माया शङ्कराचार्यमाश्रये। प्रह्लादवरदो देवो यो नृसिंहः परो हरिः नृसिंहोपासकं नित्यं तन्नृसिंहगुरुं भजे। श्रीसच्चिदानन्दशिवाभिनव्यनृसिंहभारत्यभिधान्यतीन्द्रान् विद्यानिधीन्मन्त्रनिधीन् सदात्मनिष्ठान् भजे मानवशम्भुरूपान्। सदात्मध्याननिरतं विषयेभ्यः पराङ्मुखं नौमि शास्त्रेषु निष्णातम् चन्द्रशेखरभारतीं। विवेकिनं महाप्रज्ञं धैर्योदार्यक्षमानिधिं सदाभिनवपूर्वन्तं विद्यातीर्थगुरुं भजे। भारतीकरुणापात्रं भारतीपदभूषणम् भारतीपदमारूढं भारतीतीर्थमाश्रये। भारतीतीर्थपर्यन्तं भक्तहृत्तापनाशनं भवभीतिहरं देवं भावये सततं हृदि। विद्याविनयसम्पन्नौ वीतरागौ विवेकिनम् वन्दे वेदान्ततत्त्वज्ञौ विधुशेखरभारतीम्। अनंत गुण संपन्नाम अनंताभिधयाश्रुताम अनंत ज्ञान दात्रीं ताम मातरम प्रणुमो वयम गैर्वाण्या संविबोधेन जीवनं मौल्य संयुतं याकरोत्तान्नमाम्यम्बां शारदामूर्तरूपिणीम्। चूड़ालंकृत शशिकलाभ्यां निजतपःफलाभ्यां भक्तेषु प्रकटित फलाभ्यां भवतु मे शिवाभ्यामस्तोकत्रिभुवन शिवाभ्यां हृदि पुनर्भवाभ्यां आनन्दस्फुरदनुभवाभ्यान्नतिरियम्।
To start learning the eighth one because ninth one, because like I said, we will be revising 1 to 10 after we complete learning the tenth verse, following which we have individual chanting. So as we'll be doing the revision of the previous
verses, then now we will start with the new verse directly. Aditi. कासारे
गभीरे कासारे गभीरे कासारे
विशति विजने घोर विपिने
विशति विजने घोर विपिने विशति विजने घोर विपिने
विशाले शैले च
विशाले शैले च विशाले शैले च
भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः
भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः
समर्प्यैकं
समर्प्यैकम् समर्प्यैकम्
चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते
चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते
सुखेनावस्थातुम्
सुखेनावस्थातुम् सुखेनावस्थातुम्
जन इह न जानाति किमहो
जन इह न जानाति किमहो जन इह न जानाति किमहो
गभीरे भ इज महाप्राणा घो इज महाप्राण विशाले शैले च भ्रमति भ इज महाप्राण कुसुमार्थम थ इज महाप्राण जडमति ही सो कुसुमार्थम जडमति ही व्हेन वी कंबाइन द अनुस्वार विद द ज इट बिकम्स कुसुमार्थन जडमति ही समर्प्यैकम नोट द संयुक्ताक्षर संयुक्ताक्षर मीन्स कंजंक्ट कॉन्सनेंट्स विच हैव मोर देन वन कॉन्सनेंट टुगेदर अलॉन्ग विद द स्वर समर्प्यैकम ऋ एंड प एंड य ऑल शुड बी हर्ड क्लियरली समर्प्यैकम अगेन हियर समर्प्यैकम चेतः व्हेन यू कंबाइन द अनुस्वार एंड च इट बिकम्स समर्प्यैकं चेतः सरसिज मुमानाथ थ इज महाप्राण भवते भ इज महाप्राण सुखेनावस्थातुम खे इज महाप्राण सुखेन अवस्थातुम अवस्थातुं, थ इज महाप्राण, प्लीज नोट द द्वित्वम देयर डबलिंग, सुखेनावस्थातुं, स नोट द डबलिंग ऑफ दैट, जन इह न जानाति किमहो. इट्स वन थिंग हियर, ए ओ आई इन संस्कृतम आर ऑलवेज दीर्घ, दैट इज दे आर ऑलवेज लॉन्ग वोवेल्स, सो वी डोंट हैव ए, इट इज ए ऑलवेज, एंड वी डोंट हैव ओ, इट इज ऑलवेज ओ. सिमिलरली वी डो, आई इज ऑल्सो ऑलवेज अ दीर्घ, ऑलवेज अ लॉन्ग लेटर. सो लेट अस डू वन लाइन एट अ टाइम. गभीरे कासारे विशति विजने घोर विपिने,
गभीरे कासारे विशति विजने घोर विपिने, गभीरे कासारे विशति विजने घोर विपिने,
विशाले शैले च भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः,
विशाले शैले च भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः, विशाले शैले च भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः,
समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते,
समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते, समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते,
सुखेनावस्थातुं जन इह न जानाति किमहो,
सुखेनावस्थातुं जन इह न जानाति किमहो, सुखेनावस्थातुं जन इह न जानाति किमहो,
गभीरे कासारे विशति विजने घोर विपिने, विशाले शैले च भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः,
गभीरे कासारे विशति विजने घोर विपिने, विशाले शैले च भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः, गभीरे कासारे विशति विजने घोर विपिने, विशाले शैले च भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः,
समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते, सुखेनावस्थातुं जन इह न जानाति किमहो,
समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते, सुखेनावस्थातुं जन इह न जानाति किमहो, समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते, सुखेनावस्थातुं जन इह न जानाति किमहो.
फुल श्लोक. गभीरे कासारे विशति विजने घोर विपिने, विशाले शैले च भ्रमति कुसुमार्थं जडमतिः, समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते, सुखेनावस्थातुं जन इह न जानाति किमहो.
गभीरे कासारे विशति विजने घोर विपिने, विशाले शैले च भ्रमति कुसुमार्थंजडमतिः समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते सुखेनावस्थातुं जन इह न जानाति किमहो।
उत्तमम्।
गभी
वी विल गो टू द मीनिंग एंड देन वी विल चैंट वंस अगेन। सो इन दिस वर्स शंकराचार्य इज टेलिंग अस हाउ इफ वी कुड जस्ट ऑफर आर माइंड चेतस सरसिजम टू भगवान, टू उमानाथा, टू ईश्वरा, दैट इटसेल्फ इज एवरीथिंग। That itself is sufficient. All we need to do is very simple. It is to offer our antahkaranam, to offer our chetaha means mind. Sarasijam is lotus. So the mind is compared to a lotus. So like we learnt in the previous class, in one of the verses, Acharya told us that all my faculties, including my mind, intellect, all my senses, everything may it be may dwell in Lord Shiva. Similarly, in this verse, he's saying Umanatha, again addressing Ishvara, vocative case, O Umanatha, O Lord of Uma, O Lord of Parvati. One mind lotus by just samarpya, having offered that to you, what else is needed? Nothing else. But that it sounds very simple in the sense that you don't need any things for doing it. You don't need to have anything else. Rather, just you can just wherever you are at whatever time, whichever place and situation, just wholeheartedly offering the entire mind to Parameshwara. That itself is ultimate. That is the path to Shivanandam. But is that very simple? The mind is like a monkey, it keeps going here and there. For that, we need all the sadhanas and should stotram and puja, and also to attain that chetas, that shuddhi, antahkarana shuddhi. Only then it will be easy to offer the entire mind to Parameshwara. So, with this bhava, our Acharya Shankara is now telling us how gabhire kasare. In a very deep lake. If one wants to find a flower in a very deep lake, diving into a deep lake, it is not easy, right? It is not an easy task. So, going into a deep lake and finding a flower to give to Parameshwara, or Vijane means without people. Jana means people. Vijane means without people. So, in a place which doesn't have people, that is in a deserted place, Dishati enters. So, either going into a deep lake to find a flower or to enter a Nirjana place where there are no people, Vijane, where the deserted place. So, entering such a place, Ghora Vipine, in a frightening forest. Vipinam is forest. Ghora means terrible or frightening. So, entering a terrible forest with a lot of wild animals, etc. To just find a flower for offering to Parameshwara. Vishale Shaile cha. Vishale is very expansive. So in a very vast, Shaila means mountain. Cha means and. So and in a very vast mountain. Kusumartham jadamatihi. So in order to find a flower, Kusuma means flower. Kusumartham for a flower, jadamatihi, meaning the one who is not very wise, such a person would be wandering where either in Gabhire Kasare in a very deep lake or entering a deserted place or in a Ghora Vipina in a very terrible forest or in a vast mountain, Kusumartham bhramati. So such a person is wandering there to find a flower, thinking that if I find such a flower with all this effort, only then Parameshwara will be pleased. But is that true? That is what Shankaracharya is trying to create awareness here in us. Umanatha, O Umanatha, bhavate for you. Ekam chetasarasijam samarpya. Just by offering one chetasarasijam. Note the beautiful comparison. So here, in all such difficult places, a person is trying to find a flower. But one mind flower, chetasarasijam, lotus actually. Sarasijam is lotus. Just by offering one mind lotus to you, Umanatha, ekam chetasarasijam bhavate samarpya, janaha iha sukhena avasthatum najanati kim aho, aho najanati kim. Aho means exclamation. Oh, aho, you find an exclamation very frequently used in Sanskritam. How can a person not know that just, or how can a person not remain happy? Sukhena avasthatum, to remain calm and happy, just by offering that chetasarasijam to Umanatha. Janaha means a person or people. Iha najanati kim, the people here do not know, is it? O Umanatha, don't the people know that just by offering, completely offering that one mind lotus to you, they can remain happy? So why do they have to undertake all these arduous journeys of trying to go in a mountain and finding a particular flower and all that? Is all that necessary? So the inner meaning here is, what is important is the bhava with which you do the puja. So whatever you do, you might think I'm going to undertake a lot of rituals, etc. But if your mind is not offered to Parameshwara, if that sattvika bhakti is not there, then all that is of no consequence. Whereas, whether you do anything or not, if you completely offer your mind, chetasarasijam, to Parameshwara, what else is needed to attain Shivanandam? What a beautiful verse. So, this reminds us of a very famous stotram called Shiva Manasa Puja, composed by our Adi Shankara Bhagavat Padacharya. Most of you might have heard it. If not, I urge you to please listen to it, which is why I have shared a link in the chat box. I hope you're able to the first chat today. So I've shared a YouTube link. So all of you, please try to. Yeah, I think I shared it. I shared it in the Q&A, I think, now.
So, all of you, please go through that stotram called Shiva Manasa Puja. It is a wonderful stotram. It starts like Ratnanihi Kalpita Masanam.
So again, to Ishvara, Shankaracharya is offering the best Manasa Puja in his mind. What is he giving? Ratnaihi Kalpitam Asanam. He is giving an asana, a seat to Parameshwara, which is made out of gems. Ratnaihi Kalpitam Asanam. Himajalaihi Snanam. Abhishekam with the fresh water melting from the Himalayas. Snanancha Divyambaram. Very holy ambaram, garment. Nana ratna vibhushitam mrigamada modankitam chandanam. Chandanam is nana ratna vibhushitam, decorations with lot of gems. Mrigamada modankitam chandanam. Chandanam is that musk or holy chandana. Jati champaka bilva patra rachitam pushpam cha dhupam tatha. Various flowers, jati, champaka, and the bilva patra, that is the leaf, bilva leaf. Bilva patra, jati champaka bilva patra rachitam dhupam cha dhupam tatha. Ratnai kalpita masanam himajalaihi snanam cha divyambaram. Nana ratna vibhushitam mrigamada modankitam chandanam. Jati champaka bilva patra rachitam pushpam cha dhupam tatha deepam, there the lamp, deva dayanidhe, o ocean of mercy, pashupate hritkalpitam grihyatam. Where is all this created? Hritkalpitam, in my heart I am making all this for you. Grihyatam, please accept. So there are five verses in this Shiva Manasa Puja. All this, I mean, Chatram, Chamarayor Yugam, Vejanakam Cha, Adarshakam, Nirmalam, everything he gives, Chatra, Chamara, everything. How is he actually getting these? No, but in his mind, he is thinking of all this. And Sankalpena Samarpitam Tava Vibho, Pujam Grihana Prabho. By Sankalpa, in his mind, Hritkalpitam, he is giving. So every verse, and then Atmatvam girijamati sahacharaha prana shariram griham pujate vishayopa bhogarachana nidra samadhi sthitihi sancharav padayoho pradakshina vidhihi stotrani sarvagiro yat yat karma karomi tattad akhilam shambho tavaradhanam. I think in the fourth verse he says, whatever I do, let my walk be pradakshina to you, let my speech be stotram to you, yat yat karma karomi, whatever I do with this human form, whatever I do with using my faculties, tat tat akhilam, let everything in that, shambho tava aradhanam, O Shambho, let all that become an aradhana to you. So there, Shiva Manasa Puja, Shankaracharya has advocated this in many places, telling us the importance of offering the mind to Parameshwara and not blindly following certain rituals. This doesn't mean that puja and aradhana are not important. No, puja aradhana are important for attaining that chitta shuddhi. But for that, it is most important to know the underlying meaning and also to know that the mind should be offered to Bhagavan first. That is more important than anything else. So I urge you all, we are doing this Shivananda Lahari course. I urge you all to go through Shiva Manasa Puja. It is a very wonderful stotram, all by imagination. The entire puja and beautifully described in the mind, you sit there and you offer everything to Parameshwara. Wherever you are, at whatever time, whatever you are doing, you can just sit where you are and offer to Parameshwara. And that is the path to Shivanandam. So, a very beautiful verse. And I urge all of you to chant this verse now by enjoying the meaning. Aditi, could you chant this verse once, please?
Gabhire kasare vishati vijane ghora vipine vishale shaile cha bhramati kusumarthan jadamati hi समर्प्यैकञ्चेतः सरसिजमुमानाथ भवते सुखेनावस्थातुं च न इह न जानाति किमहो.
If you're able to find the link to the WhatsApp group, kindly share it. Some of them are asking for it. In case you're able to find, kindly share it in the Q&A or in the chat for everyone.
Narattvam devatvam.
Nagavana mrigatvam mashakata.
Nagavana mrigatvam mashakata. Nagavana mrigatvam mashakata.
Pashutvam kitatvam.
Pashutvam kitatvam. Pashutvam kitatvam.
Bhavatu vihagatvadi jananam.
Bhavatu vihagatvadi jananam. Bhavatu vihagatvadi jananam.
Sadatvat padabjasmarana paramananda lahari.
Sadatvat padabjasmarana paramananda lahari. सदात्वत्पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी
विहारासक्तं चेत्
विहारासक्तं चेत् विहारासक्तं चेत्
हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा
हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा
उत्तमं नरत्वं देवत्वं हियर प्लीज नोट द द्वित्वं नरत्वं त इज डबलिंग नरत्वं व्हेन द अनुस्वार कंबाइंस विद दे नरत्वं देवत्वं सो इंस्टेड ऑफ नरत्वं देवत्वं वी चेंज द नरत्वं देवत्वं अगेन द्वित्वं हियर नागवन मृगत्वं द्वित्वं अगेन हियर नागवन मृगत्वं मशकता पशु Twam. Again, dvitvam. Wherever that naratvam, devatvam, all that, they should note the dvitvam. Pashutvam, when anuswara combines with ki, pashutvam ki tattvam. So instead of pashutvam, pashutvam ki tattvam. So again, dvitvam there. Bhavatu, bha is mahaprana. Vihagatvadi jananam. Vihagatva, note the dvitvam again. Vihagatvadi jananam. Sadat. सदात्वत् पादाब्जस्मरण नोट देयर आर मल्टीपल द्वित्वम्स इन दिस लाइन सदात्वत् पादाब्जस्मरण परमानंद लहरी यू शुड नॉट स्प्लिट देयर अगेन यू सी अ हाइफन हियर सो वी हैव टू चैंट बोथ द लाइंस टुगेदर व्हाइल लर्निंग वी विल लर्न फर्स्ट टाइम व्हाइल लर्निंग वी विल लर्न द थर्ड लाइन सेपरेटली बट अगेन व्हाइल चैंटिंग वी शुड नॉट स्प्लिट आफ्टर लहरी नो पॉज It's one word, samasta padam or compound word. Paramananda lahari viharasaktam. Viharasaktam, anuswara combined by cha. Viharasaktan ched. So, note the sandhi there. Hridayamiha kim tena. Kim, anuswara followed by the kim tena. That becomes the sandhi. Kim tena vapusha. Note the difference. Mashakata, this sha, shivaha, shankaraha, shubham. Mashakata, sha. Here, last word here. Vapusha, sha. Your tongue is turning. Vapusha. Like how you pronounce tatha dadhana. Like that, the tongue will turn upwards. Vapusha. So that sha and sha. There is a reason why we have two of them. We cannot chant both similarly. We should note the difference while chanting. Here, viharasaktan chet. So there also, dvitvam can appear at the end of a word also. So chet. But we should not make it sound like u. Chet is also correct. If you just say chet or viharasaktan. We are following dvitvam everywhere so that slight second th is heard, but it should not be heard as u. That we should note. Let us repeat.
Naratvam devatvam. नगवन मृगत्वं मशकता नरत्वं देवत्वं नगवन मृगत्वं मशकता
पशुत्वं कीटत्वं भवतु विहगत्वादि जननम्
पशुत्वं कीटत्वं भवतु विहगत् त्वादि जननम् पशुत्वं कीटत्वं भवतु विहगत्वादि जननम्
सदा त्वत्पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत्
सदा त्वत् पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत् सदा त्वत्पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत्
हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा।
हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा
उत्तमम्। नौ टू टू लाइन्स एट अ टाइम। नरत्वं देवत्वं नगवन मृगत्वं मशकता पशुत्वं कीटत्वं भवतु विहगत्वादिजननम्।
नरत्वं देवत्वं नगवनमृगत्वं मशकता पशुत्वं कीटत्वं भवतु विहगत्वादिजननम् नरत्वं देवत्वं नगवनमृगत्वं मशकता पशुत्वं कीटत्वं भवतु विहगत्वादिजननम्
सदा त्वत्पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत् हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा।
सदा त्वत्पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत् हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा
चारु द्वित्वम् देर विहारासक्तं चेत्।
विहारासक्तं चेत् हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा
उत्तमम्। थर्ड लाइन अगेन। थर्ड एंड फोर्थ लाइन टुगेदर।
सदा त्वत्पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत् हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा
Uttamam. Now we'll do the entire verse. You can repeat once, then I will tell the meaning. Naratvam devatvam nagavana mrigatvam mashakata pashutvam kitatvam bhavatu vihagatvadi jananam सदात्वत् पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत् हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा।
नरत्वं देवत्वं नगवनमृगत्वं मशकता पशुत्वं कीटत्वं भवतु विहगत्वादिजननं सदा त्वत्पादाब्जस्मरण परमानन्दलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत् हृदयमिह किं तेन वपुषा
Tamam. So, in this verse, Acharya Shankara is telling us that when the heart is dwelling, or when the mind is dwelling in the lotus feet of Parameshwara, Tvat Padabjasmarana, Sada, always, Tvat, your Padabjasmarana, again lotus feet, abja means lotus, Padabja, your lotus feet, smarana, thinking of Paramananda Lahari. So initially Shivananda Lahari, we saw the usage of that. Here Paramananda Lahari, it's the same, Shivananda is only Paramananda. We cannot get Paramananda from any worldly sources. So only sources, Parameshwara himself. So Paramananda Lahari Viharasaktam. So when the mind is always dwelling in the lotus feet of Parameshwara and experiencing the bliss of Paramananda, Vihara Asaktam, Vihara shows again always absorbed and reveling in that Paramananda. Then Vapusha Kim, then what is the, what difference does the body make? Vapuhu means body. So Kim Tena Vapusha, what difference does a body make, a form make? So we all know that a jiva goes through many births. Like Shankaracharya says in Mohamudgaram, Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam, Punarapi Janani, Jathare Shayanam. So until one attains moksha, one is liberated from this cycle of birth and death, there is Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam. And based on the karma, the jiva attains various forms. Could be the human form, which is supposed to be the most conducive to attain moksha. Which is why in Viveka Chudamani, Shankaracharya says, Durlabham Trayam Etat Daivanugraha Hetukam. There are three things which are very difficult to attain, which one can attain only with Daivanugraha, with the blessings of Bhagavan, Daiva Anugraha. What are those three things? Manushyatvam, this human form. It comes only when with good karma. Mumukshutvam, and after attaining this human form, the urge to attain moksha. That is also very rare. Then Mahapurusha Samshrayaha, that is being under the guidance or under the protection of a Mahapurusha, that is having a guru to lead you in the right path. So being under the protection of a Mahapurusha, a realized soul, is also very difficult. So three things, Manushyatva, Mumukshutva, Mahapurusha Samshrayaha. They say Narajanma Ativa Durlabham, it is very difficult to get this. And once you get this, we should know that ultimate goal. And this form is supposed to be the most conducive among all other forms, like insects, amphibians, reptiles, the terrestrial animals, birds, plants. There are so many creatures, right, in this world. So compared to all those, it is said that the human form is most conducive to moksha. However, in this verse, Shankaracharya is telling us, whether you have Naratvam, the form of a human being, or Devatvam, the form of a celestial being. Naga Vana Mrigatvam. Naga means Nagachati iti Nagaha, that which does not move. So Naga is a synonym for mountain. Naga Vana Mrigatvam. So the animals living in mountains or in forests. Mashakata, the form of a mosquito. Pashutvam, the form of any animal, Pashu or cattle also. Pashu also means cattle. Ketatvam, insect or a worm. So, all these forms are there. Vihagatvadi Jananam. Vihaga means birds. Vihagatvadi, etc. Birds, etc. Jananam, that is birth. Bhavatu. So, may the birth be in any form, be it the human form or celestial being or animals, whether living in mountains or in forests or in the form of a mosquito or a pashu or a worm or a bird. However, sada hridayam tvat padabja smarana paramananda lahari viharasaktam chet tena vapusha kim. However, when the heart is always dwelling in the paramananda, shivananda, that eternal bliss of the lotus feet of Parameshwara, then what difference does this body make? So it is true that human form is conducive for moksha. However, we have many instances where animals and insects, etc., have also attained Paramatma. We have many such instances in our Puranas and stories. One such example which comes to mind is Shri Kalahasti. Right near Tirupati, it's a very famous kshetram of, it is one of the Panchabhuta kshetras of Parameshwara. So you all can read up about the story of Shri Kalahasti in case you haven't before. So there the Vayulinga, the name itself, Shri Kalahasti, Shri Kalahastishwara, the name itself comes because three creatures there, that is a spider, a serpent and an elephant. All these three were extremely devoted to Ishvara and all the three attained mukti in that holy kshetra. That is why it is called Shri Kalahasti. So do read up on that, on the kshetra mahima there. And In the Ramayanam, we have so many examples, right? Ramayanam, the greatness is Rama. He showered his love and affection on all beings, not just humans, on Jatayu and on that squirrel. So Rama was, whoever, and Jatayu attained moksha after having the darshan of Rama. Rama performed his last rites for Jatayu. And that squirrel also helped Rama to, in whatever way it could, to build that bridge across the ocean. And Sampati, he helped in Ramakaryam. When he heard that Jatayu, his brother, was no more, he narrates the, he says that I can see at a very, my eyesight is so good that I can see for so many yojanas that Sita is there in Lanka. Ravana has kept her captive there. So then Hanuman and others who are searching for Sita get an idea, get a clue. So Sampati directs them. And when he is saying this, because he helped in the Ramakarya, his wings, which were burnt long ago, they come back to him. So we have so many instances where birds, animals, etc. have attained. And very famous instance, of course, of Gajendra Moksha, right? The Gajendra in previous birth was a king who was called Indradyumna, who was meditating on Vishnu and did not see that Agastya Muni came there. So he was cursed to become an elephant. And when that Gajendra was caught by the crocodile and all his companions left him and he realized that his strength is nothing and he's unable to free himself, he surrenders completely and calls out to Vishnu, that primordial source of the universe. And he offers a lotus, Pushpam. And then Vishnu comes extremely fast on his Garuda and he releases the elephant Gajendra from the crocodile. So this is another instance where an elephant also attained moksha by surrendering to Vishnu. So there are many instances like that where even when the heart is surrendered to, or when the heart is dwelling in that Paramananda of Parameshwara, Kim Tena Vapusha, what difference does this body make? So let us go through the overall meaning. And then we will chant this verse once. Let birth take place in any form, whether as a human, a celestial being, an animal living in forests and mountains, a mosquito, cattle, worm, or a bird, it does not matter. As long as the heart is always immersed in the blissful joy of remembering your lotus feet, then what does the form of the body matter? Then how does the form matter in any way? Okay, so let us chant. Charu, could you chant this once?
Naratvam devatvam nagavana mrigatvam mashakata pashutvam kitatvam bhavatu vihagatvadi jananam sadatvat पादाब्जस्मरण परमानंदलहरी विहारासक्तं चेत हृदयमिह किंतेन वपुषा.
उत्तमम चारु. थैंक यू अदिति. शी हैज शेयर्ड द लिंक फॉर द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप अगेन. आई एम अनेबल टू कॉपी इट. If Aditi is there, request you to please answer to one of the Q&As if possible, or you could. Aditi has shared in the chat, so I think all of you will be able to see it. She has shared it with everyone. We will conclude with Shanti Mantraha. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah. सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. राम राम राम. सर्वेभ्यः धन्यवादाः. थैंक यू फॉर अटेंडिंग. थैंक यू टू आवर पैनलिस्ट्स चारु एंड अदिति फॉर वेरी इफेक्टिवली असिस्टिंग अस. And we will continue individual chanting in the next class, as some of you have requested that you want to chant. So please practice the first 10 verses. धन्यवादाः, पुनर्मिलामः, राम राम राम।